दोस्तों, फल सब्जियों में मिलावट और बढ़ते प्रदूषण की खबरों से परेशान लोगों में से कुछ लोग महंगी ऑर्गेनिक सब्जियों की तरफ रुझान कर रहे हैं, तो कुछ अब खुद अपने घरों में फल सब्जियां उगाना चाहते हैं ताकि उनके परिवार को शुद्ध खाना मिल सके। अगर फल सब्जी के ये पौधे आपके आंखों के सामने बड़े होते हैं और उनसे ताजे फल सब्जियां आपको खाने को मिलता है, तो यकीनन आप खुश जरूर होंगे, साथ ही हम स्वस्थ भी रह पाएंगे। नमस्ते, मैं अंशु कुमार आप सभी का स्वागत करती हूँ ग्रीन टीवी में, और स्वागत है आपका आज के इस खास वेबिनार में जिसका आयोजन बिजोमिया और ग्रीन टीवी के संयुक्त प्रयास से किया गया है। पिछले 1.5 सालों से पूरी दुनिया कोरोना वायरस के कारण ठहर सी गई है। महामारी की दूसरी लहर में भारत में भी इसके मामले लगातार बढ़ते दिखे, जो कि पिछले कई दिनों में थोड़े कम नजर आ रहे हैं। बीमारी की गंभीरता को देखते हुए ही पहले और दूसरी लहर के बीच कई राज्यों में लॉकडाउन लगाया गया और सबसे घरों में ही रहने की अपील की गई, और ये अलग बात है कि अब फिर से सब अनलॉक की तरफ धीरे धीरे बढ़ रहे हैं। ऐसे में इस मौके का फायदा आप भी उठा सकते हैं और छत पर बागवानी की शुरुआत कर सकते हैं ताकि आप खुद को और अपने परिवार को स्वस्थ रखने की तरफ एक कदम बढ़ा सकें। और इसी कड़ी में आज हमने इस वेबिनार का आयोजन किया है। बिजोमिया के साथ मिलकर आयोजित किए गए इस वेबिनार में एक्सपर्ट बताएंगे आपको बगीचे में या फिर अपने घर पर अच्छी सब्जियां व फल किस प्रकार से उगा सकते हैं। तो इस वेबिनार का आगे का कार्यभार संभालेंगे बिजोमिया के सह संस्थापक मंजीत विशाल जी। तो आइए स्वागत करते हैं मंजीत जी का, और इस वेबिनार का जो है इसको आगे बढ़ाते हैं।
थैंक यू अंशु, thank you everyone. I welcome all my participants today for the webinar, third webinar of Bizomia, you, me and green series. So taking it forward, and I like to welcome my both of the speakers present today with us, Mr. Rajshekhar Patoli sir and Dr. Alka Singh madam. Before starting the webinar, I like to thank all my participants who have been supporting out our initiative since last 2 weeks. We had been witnessing so much of support from all of you. First webinar went for more than 6,000 viewership, live viewership, and the second webinar went for more than 7,500. Before starting the webinar, I'd like to mention our partners on board today, our associate partner Green TV, with whom we are organizing this third session of our series, our environmental partner ARDEAF, our youth partner Enactus for LSR College, and our outreach partner Uthan, as well as our associate partner Nursery Life. A special mention to our sponsor today, Gardensia Technologies India. Taking this session forward, I'd like to share what we all are, what Bizomia is all about. So we have already spoken about what Bizomia, how the Bizomia was founded in the first webinar that we had hosted on 5th of June. So basically now Bizomia is taking a very good shape now. Our website, the B2B commerce website, is almost ready. So people are now taking interest. They are doing the registration there. We are very much happy to get them on board. Basically, Bizomia is an India-based e-commerce company intensively inclined towards the B2B procurement of the industrial supplies, in particular to horticulture, agriculture, tissue culture, and the many more industrial essentials. But why we started this B2B platform? So basically, the entire team of Bizomia is having the expertise, the experience from the very same industry of horticulture since last more than two or three decades. Basically, in the last few years, we had witnessed few very important problems for which there should be a solution to those problems. First was that in this particular sector, the role of the technology was still very limited. So very limited technological intervention was in this sector. First was the thing that we have witnessed in the last 4 to 5 years of our working. Second, that they are, because the kind of intervention of the technologies as the time was passing out, so there are a lot of mishappening use happening at all around this sector. So we've identified the second factor, that there is a very huge loss, lack of the credibility and the trust. Similarly, it results for the unfair business opportunities and the information flow in the entire sector. And then last was the inadequate knowledge transfer. So keeping in consideration all these factors that we had experienced the last 3 to 5 years, so what we are doing in under this Bizomia platform, basically we are working on the 4 thematic pillars. First is that we are creating this social e-commerce platform where everybody will have that liberty of creating their own shop, where the KRA will be done, so you have having a very credential, verified and a certified shops where you can actually look into and then you can shop from. The second thing that we are focusing is upon the upskills and the reskills thing, because without the use of the knowledge, you are not nowhere going ahead. So if we take in consideration the kind of knowledge or the kind of practice our European countries are now going ahead with, the Netherlands, Spain, Italy. whomsoever it is, they are going too high from us. So how we can actually do this knowledge, know-how transfer and all. So this upskill and the reskill is the second thematic pillar of which we are focusing out. Third is the predictive analysis thing. Actually, we don't know the next year what kind of product and what is the quantum of product we are supposed to raise out. So the third component where Bizomia will focus will be the predictive analysis thing. And definitely the infrastructural support part will be the fourth pillar, because still we are struggling with how to do this whole logistical arrangement thing, the infrastructural support and everything. So Bizomia will basically focus on these four thematic pillars of social e-commerce, upskill and reskill, predictive analysis and the infrastructural support. Just to carry this forward, we had created a 1 minute video, and I'll just like you all to first see this video and then we'll take forward this webinar.
Bizomia is a B2B platform inclined towards procurement of industrial supplies. In particular, horticulture, agriculture, tissue culture, and many more industry essentials using integrated technological interventions. The platform works on four thematic pillars. Be collaborative across the industry. Be authoritative educators. Be influential advocates. And be fervent supporters of plant businesses promoting healthy and green communities. The platform is a network providing business solutions to more than 30,000 plus nurserymen across the country and connecting them with more than 1 lakh business options. The platform is also into publications, training and workshops, study tours, reskills and upskills, and many such activities to engage and promote the farmers and growers across the country.
Thank you. Without wasting much time, I'd like to request my first speaker today, Mr. Rajshekhar Patlori, sir. So to introduce him, Mr. Rajshekhar Patlori is basically from Hyderabad, Telangana, and he is basically a spiritual scientist. We had heard a lot about him, so we'll look forward to listen to his presentation today. His goal is basically to provide a greater understanding regarding the nature of our multidimensional reality. And he also researched organic, natural and the spiritual farming, which rooted in the timeless wisdom and the oldest practices. So welcome Rajshekhar sir on board today with us on the Bizomia platform, and over to you, sir.
Namaste. Thank you, friends. So nowadays we hear a lot about organic farming and then moving forward natural farming, and then there's also some mention about spiritual farming that you must be hearing on and off. But my real focus is to help us to understand more about spiritual farming and how we can apply it to use it in our own homes by a small do-it-yourself home gardening. Even with the shortage of space, we'll be able to use certain basic gardening principles, the natural farming and spiritual farming principles, to create a home garden on your terrace. And this is what I did personally, and I'll just share some of my experiences with this. Before that, I'll take you through a presentation which will explain to you about the evolution of our understanding of farming. In fact, there's no real evolution of farming, because farming itself is something that has happened. So I'll just start sharing the presentation. Yes. Yes.
Sir, I think your presentation is yet to come on the screen.
Yeah, it's there on the screen right now.
We can't see that.
Okay. So I just selected it. Was coming all right earlier. Maybe I just open it again. Okay.
Sir, you can just open it again. In this meantime, I'll like to introduce our associate partner, Green TV. So there is a, just a 40-second clip of Green TV. We can just run that out. And meanwhile, you can suggest to open out your place.
Okay.
So just to introduce.
सूरज की पहली किरण के संग जाते हैं हम खेतों में उगाने अन्न.
सर्दी गर्मी हो या बरसात करते हैं हम मेहनत दिन रात.
दिखती है हमारी जिंदगी आसान पर हमारा काम नहीं है आप.
ग्रीन टीवी को हमारा सम्मान, इनसे मिली हमें पहचान.
मैं हूँ किसान,
मैं हूँ किसान,
मैं हूँ किसान,
मैं हूँ किसान,
हम है किसान,
हम है किसान.
भारत की शान.
Can we have the speaker on the screen now? Sir, is the presentation ready?
The presentation was there. It was, I don't know why it's not coming onto the screen. Earlier it had come when we tested it.
Yeah.
So, what's the... Maybe I will bring it into the same. Yeah, one second. We'll try it out now.
So we can see that. You can start it, sir.
Yeah, now you can see it, right?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yes. Namaste, friends. This is Rajshekar Kotluri from Quantum Life University. And I'm going to talk to you about spiritual agriculture. Like I said, we have been hearing over the years about organic farming, organic agriculture, natural farming, and then this term spiritual agriculture is also being used nowadays. But I would like to share a more refined perspective and understanding of what spiritual agriculture actually is. And this is our organization, Quantum Life University, where we are building a spiritual university to bring in ancient wisdom and use it for the benefit of the modern world today, so that everyone can benefit from these ancient wisdom that has been there since thousands of years. Spiritual agriculture is a simple means of like persons who have spiritual interests related to agriculture, the environment, food, domestic animals, and it's not just about plants itself, plants, animals, and about our ecology and about the environment completely. A holistic view to environment is what is spiritual agriculture. So
I think you can just start the presentation, sir, because we can just see your folder, not the presentation.
Okay. Yeah, now can you see the presentation?
Yet not, sir.
Okay. Yes. Is that okay now?
Yes, sir. You can please go ahead, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, sorry. So I'm just repeating about the spiritual agriculture and what it entails. And I'm Rajshekar from Quantum Life University. And spiritual agriculture is a holistic approach to agriculture involving not just plants, but the whole environment, humans, and our relationship to the environment. So in order to understand spiritual agriculture, we must start from our contemporary agriculture, and then we go to organic agriculture, natural agriculture, and spiritual agriculture. Quickly run through it in a minute or two. So contemporary agriculture, what we know as of today, is by the use of chemical fertilizer. It's not the old agriculture that we used to do. In fact, the ancient agriculture was always spiritual agriculture because they understood the spiritual agriculture practices. Then now, later we move to something called organic agriculture from the contemporary agriculture of using chemical fertilizers and pesticides. And that meant that we don't use any chemical fertilizers or pesticides, and we call that organic agriculture. We could use biopesticides and biofertilizer, but not chemicals, and that's organic. The next step was natural, where we started using things like cow products, jivamrut, and other products related to the animals, and we became closer to the olden ways of doing agriculture, and that came to be called as natural agriculture or natural farming. And then we have spiritual farming. Now, spiritual farming is my area of interest, and we're going to talk about that towards the later part of the presentation. So some of the pioneers I'm going to talk to you about: one, Masanobu Fukuoka, who started this revolution. I'm not going to talk much about the conventional and organic because a lot has been spoken about and a lot of people know about these things, about organic farming. Masanobu Fukuoka is a Japanese pioneer in agriculture who started this concept of natural farming, and he started coming out with some amazing concepts saying that we need to grow like how things grow in nature. For instance, how do things grow in a forest? Does anyone till the land? Does anyone apply nutrients, fertilizer? None of these things are done, but still they grow. So you try to grow things as close to nature as possible, and that's the concept of natural farming. And his international bestseller, which is called The One Straw Revolution, really revolutionized the way farming was done, and this natural farming came to be accepted practice worldwide. So there are a few no's in the cultivation in normal farming, and he says no to plowing or tilling the soil, no to chemical fertilizer, and not even prepared compost. And then he talks about no weeding or tillage. He says we handle the weeds in a different way. In his concept of farming, even the weeds are converted into fertilizer by killing them in ways, just in very simple ways, by, for instance, you cover the weed with, say, straw, and then because of lack of sunlight, the weeds die, and then the weeds then become fertilizer for your plants. So such an amazing concept. He says no need of even weeding. And then the fourth concept, of course, is no dependence on chemicals of any kind, either for fertilizer or for the pesticides. Some of his wonderful quotes. He says, unless people can become natural people, there can be neither natural farming nor natural food. Such an amazing statement. He says, giving up your ego is the shortest way to unification with nature. He says, if we throw Mother Nature out of the window, then Mother Nature comes back at us with a vengeance, with a pitchfork. And that's what is happening with this coronavirus, because we have been throwing Mother Nature out of the window and all these years, and Mother Nature has come back at us with this, in the form of this coronavirus. So he also says, my ultimate dream is to sow seeds in the deserts. Like he says, it's possible to make the deserts into green, lush green lands. He says, the irony of science is that it has served to show how small human knowledge is. There is so much to be known, but he says, we hardly know anything. Then we have our own Indian pioneer, Padma Shri Subhash Palekar, who came up with zero-based natural farming, in which he said he emphasized the use of natural practices, practices that have been in place since thousands of years in India. And one of the predominant things is about the use of the cow. He started off with talking to people and teaching them, I mean, showing them how much havoc has been caused by the indiscriminate use of chemical fertilizers and chemical pesticides. And these are some of the statistics that he has shown. And he says that chemical farming is a debt trap. And that's the reason why people are falling into this debt trap and farmers are committing suicide, because they're not able to come out of this debt trap. And some of his amazing quotes are, the soil has an abundance of all nutrients. You don't need to look outside of the soil to look at nutrients. He says it's possible to grow best quality crops without chemical fertilizers and pesticides. And this is contrary to our contemporary thinking of agriculture, in which we have been taught since last one generation at least that the more fertilizers you use and the more chemical pesticides you use, the better the crops are going to be and the healthier they're going to be. But nothing can be further from the truth. And he says nature teaches. If we just are observant, we can learn from nature, and nature will teach us everything that we need to know. He says the key role is played by microorganisms, and all we need to do is nurture the microorganisms and they will create all the required nutrition that is required for the plants. And he also explains the evil effects of chemical fertilizers and pesticides. He says you adopt the principles of nature in farming using freely available, locally available ingredients and not using any commercially sold ingredients. So the prince, and he has come up with some amazing books. They are like The Philosophy of Spiritual Farming, Part 1, Part 2, some of his amazing books. Then at the Quantum Life University, we have been practicing spiritual farming for the past more than 10 years. And here are some of our team members, including Dr. Newton, the founder of Quantum Life University in the light blue kurta, and beside him, his wife, Dr. Lakshmi, the co-founder of Quantum Life University, and other team members. We also had a wonderful chance to visit another great pioneer, one Sri Narayan Reddy. He is no more. He passed away a few years ago. In just 4 acres of land, he had 75 big trees, and he grew all this in a span of just few years on that 4-acre farm. And it's an amazing thing. No use of any chemical fertilizers or pesticides anywhere. And this is our team there at the Quantum Life University, where I also had the good fortune to be there for 4 days on his farm. And this is just one part of his amazing farm. And that's Sri Narayan Reddy himself teaching us these principles and his own experiences with spiritual farming, natural farming. So now we'll come to the main aspect, which is the spiritual farming. So what exactly is spiritual farming and how is it different from all the other things that we have talked till now, including natural farming? There is one additional aspect, and that is key to spiritual farming, and that is that we need to understand that plants have consciousness, that we can communicate with plants, that they have emotions, that they understand our joy and happiness, and if we are happy, even the plants become happy. That's something that even our great scientist Jagdish Chandra Bose discovered more than 100 years ago. And this is something that we need to use. And an organization which did pioneering work in the spiritual farming field is the Swinhorn Community in Scotland, UK. And these are the founders of the Swinhorn Community way back in the 1960s. And Peter Caddy, Eileen Caddy, Dorothy McLean, and Ogilvy Crombie, these are the founders. And the founding principles of the spiritual farming or of the Swinhorn Community was deep inner listening and acting from that source of wisdom. That means you go within to find out, and you communicate with the plants will be able to communicate and tell you what exactly they need. And you co-create with the intelligence of nature in order to serve the world. The third aspect of their organization is service to the world. So this inner listening and self-knowledge, peaceful relationships and cooperation with nature and sustainability at all levels. These are the founding principles of the Swinhorn Community, and they came up with this amazing results. Huge, 10 kilo cabbages and things like that. World records, whatever they grew was world records, and absolutely no fertilizers, pesticides used at all. Everything is relating to just the communication, meditating with the plants. If the plants were not healthy, they would meditate with the plants, just make them to feel better, and they would start recovering. That's how wonderful this whole concept is. Another beautiful organization called Damanhur. It is an autonomous organization similar to our Auroville in India, and it is in Italy. And there also, the participants, all the members of that organization or that community, they have this deep bond and connection with plants and animals. And he is Roberto Airaudi, Roberto Aydor Airaudi. He is the founder of the Damanur community. And he talks about communicating with the plants, building that bond of friendship. I think those of you who have pets can easily understand that you can communicate with the animals, the pets who are in your, they become part of your own household, like members of your family. But the spiritual farming is about taking it one step further by bringing the plants also into that same level of communication and making them a part of your own family and extended family. So that's what spiritual communication, spiritual farming is all about. And we have this deeper understanding, you develop the deeper understanding, and people, and they also do it scientifically. They show how the plant responds, how it changes, how its internal biochemistry of the plant starts changing when you start communicating with it, when you start sending love to it and showing it concern. It's not just the material thing that you do, not just the watering or the fertilizer or the nutrients that you give to it. It is the love that you give to it, the sharing and the caring that you do, which is actually impacting them. And that is measurable in terms of the instruments, using different kinds of instruments. They are able to measure that. And that's what is so scientific. And that's what drew me to this. Otherwise, it's something we can say that, how can you really prove it? But we had, from the time of Jagdish Chandra Bose till now, many great scientists who actually proved that spiritual ability of plants and their ability to communicate, and the fact that plants have consciousness and how we can tap into that consciousness and improve everything. Our oneness with plants can be improved just with that. So how we can communicate with the plants? By touching the trees, by hugging the trees, you actually share that energy and love and caring with the plants. So another great master in this field is Vladimir Megre. He wrote this amazing series of books, which are called the Anastasia series of books, or also called the Ringing Siddhars series of books. He started first by communicating with the cedar trees in Siberia, and then it went on to become a great movement. And now it has a movement which has millions of followers all over the world. And he has written a series of 9 books, and a lot of spiritual farming and agriculture and plant communication is mentioned in his books. And my own experiments with farming on my terrace. This is my terrace in which I have planted using this high impact polyethylene, which is that black material that you see, made troughs out of it and placed soil, which is a combination of cocoa peat, vermicompost and dry cow dung. All this mixed properly and then placed in the troughs, and then watered regularly, and all the planting which is done. This is just one sample of the kind of troughs that I use for organic farming on my terrace. And I grow up to 25 different varieties of vegetables in my organic garden. These are some of the other troughs, the images of them. I also use smaller troughs for plants like tomatoes and okra, which is ladyfinger, bhindi. These are some of the produce that I used to get from my organic terrace garden. Cauliflowers, a wide variety of other vegetables, bitter gourd, brinjal, okra, tomatoes, bottle gourd, cochinia, which is kundru, ridge gourd, and some of the leafy vegetables, coriander, amaranth, and spinach, cabbages, all different kinds of vegetables. So thank you, friends. It was wonderful. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to share my experiences on spiritual farming. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. And it was really amazing hearing you. And जो कहते हैं ना कि मतलब इतिहास गवाह है उस चीज को अगर हम मद्देनजर रखते हुए बात करें तो वी नो द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया एंड व्हाट द लेट जेसी बोस हैज ऑलरेडी टॉट अस वे बैक कि प्लांट्स हैव लाइफ दे हैव इमोशंस दे कैन फील अस दे कैन हैव ऑल काइंड ऑफ इमोशंस लाइक दे कैन गेट हैप्पी और दे कैन गेट सैड And now it's very happy for us to see that how the entire world is recognizing that concept, the Scotland, Italy, and all the examples that you had came forward for. And I'm very much sure now, again, the kind of thing that you were carrying out, the kind of practice you were starting out in India, creating this quantum university, I'm very much sure that soon India will again be the pioneer, making the world learn again from all the kind of knowledge-based experiments that we are doing out over here. Thank you so very much, Rajshekhar sir, for giving your valuable time with us. And please be connected with us, because at the end of the webinar, we'll be taking forward with some few questions live today. Before going ahead, I'll also like to mention two of the very common issue that we have been witnessing since last two webinars. First, that we the certificate issue, that everyone are not able to download their certificate. So I'll just like to mention it over here, that it's automated system from our side. So while doing the registration with us, please be sure that you are putting up your very correct email ID, because if there is any error in your email ID, it will not generate your e-certificate. Second, we are also posting again the registration link over here. If anybody has not registered with us and they are live over here, please take out 30 seconds to register yourself again, because every participant will be getting a free e-certificate and a gift hamper from Nursery Life. Now, taking forward, I like to talk about our sponsor today, Gardensia Technologies. The Gardensia Technology is basically offering a wide range of planters. They are manufacturing a very beautiful range of planters, and they are based basically out of Gujarat, India. Gardensia basically believes in turning your garden into a gorgeous carnival of containers, usually called as planters or pots, and make sure every sapling you sow with love, it will grow with love, has its rightful home. We have a very small AV from our sponsoring agency, Gardensia Technology. So we'll just go through that, and after that, we'll have the opportunity to hear our second speaker today, Dr. Alka Singh. So first, the AV of Gardensia. So now I'll take this session forward. I'll request our second speaker, Dr. Alka Singh, to join me live today. To talk about Dr. Alka Singh. Basically, Dr. Alka Singh is professor and head of the Department of Floriculture and Landscape Architecture and the College of ASPE, College of Horticulture and Forestry, under Navsari Agriculture University. Apart from being associated with Agri Horti, she is poetress and author. She has authored lot many books. To name a few, A Color Handbook, Landscape Gardening, Handbook of Dry Flowers, Handbook of Urban Perennial and Horticulture and Sector. So taking it forward, I'll request our second speaker, Dr. Alka Singh, to join. So I had the opportunity of working with Dr. Alka ma'am since last 2 years. Welcome, ma'am, once again to the platform of the Zomia.
Very good afternoon, everyone, and many, many thanks to the Zomia and the Green TV for creating such nice programs, especially for people, and creating so much of awareness for greenery. And that is how people are taking more and more interest in plants, and people are getting more associated with gardening and with beautiful flowers and plants. So it's really nice. Now I'll just share my screen. So I'll be sharing a small video. Thank you. It is visible, no?
Yes, ma'am, we can see that very clearly. Yes, ma'am, you can just take it forward.
Yeah.
Home gardening, आप सभी जानते हैं कि बहुत प्यारी सी हॉबी है और ये सिर्फ फ्रेश एयर सिर्फ ऑक्सीजन की बात नहीं है लेकिन एक जो अलग हमें खुशी मिलती है जब हम हमारे आसपास सुंदर से प्लांट्स होते हैं सुंदर से फूल खिल रहे होते हैं एक कली आती है खिलती है और जो हमें वो जो एहसास होता है खिलने का वो एहसास हमें अंदर से भी फील होने लगता है तो इस प्यारी सी हॉबी को डिस्क्राइब करना इसकी खुशी को डिस्क्राइब करना बहुत ही मुश्किल है और जब ऑर्गेनिक होम गार्डनिंग की बात करते हैं तो इसमें मैं ये पहली चीज कहना चाहूंगी कि हमें उन स्पीसीज पे फोकस करना चाहिए जो नेटिव हो लोकल हो क्योंकि क्या है जिस तरह का एनवायरनमेंट है उस तरह के अगर प्लांट्स सेलेक्ट करेंगे हमारे नेटिव प्लांट्स तो ग्रोथ इजी होगी अच्छी भी होगी पर्यावरण के लिए भी अच्छा होगा ज्यादा अच्छा होगा जैसे आप यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं हमने कुछ फोकस किए हुए हैं वो प्लांट्स जिनको ज्यादा पानी की रिक्वायरमेंट नहीं है ठीक है तो आपको इतना ज्यादा पानी उनको नहीं देना है जैसे कि अगेव आप देख सकते हैं यहाँ पे मेरे पीछे एडेनियम्स है एडेनियम्स है वडेलिया की ये ग्राउंड कवर लगाया हुआ है और बिकॉज अभी बारिश भी शुरू हो गई है यहाँ पे साउथ गुजरात में बारिश अच्छी होती है तो हमने कुछ वाटर लिलीज भी लगाए हुए हैं और अभी अभी बारिश हुई है तो देखिए कितना सुंदर ये लुक देता है तो लोकल स्पीसीज की नेटिव प्लांट्स की जो मैं बात कर रही थी तो वो ग्राउंड कवर से लेके श्रब से लेके ट्रीज में आपको सिलेक्शन करना है यहाँ पे आप विंका का बेड आप देख सकते हैं विंका रोसिया सदाबहार के फूल इसकी हर्बल इम्पोर्टेंस भी है मेडिसिनल इम्पोर्टेंस भी है और इजी ग्रो होता है इजी सर्वाइवल है एक बार लगा दिया तो आपको फूल फूल दिखते रहेंगे थ्रू आउट द ईयर और जो कुछ ऐसे एरिया है घर के आसपास जहाँ पे कुछ कुछ रॉकी मटेरियल है या वहाँ का लैंड ठीक नहीं है उसका ऑर्गेनिक मेटेरियल इतना अच्छा नहीं है तो उसमें आप थोड़ा सा थोड़ी सी सॉइल ऐड करके उस रॉकी मटेरियल में आप कुछ रॉकरी बना सकते हो तो जैसे मैंने आपको पहले बताया एडेनियम है यूफोरबिया की कुछ स्पीसीज है अगेव या फर्केरिया है जेट्रोफा है इस तरह के आप प्लांट्स इसमें लगा सकते हैं फिर हिबिस्कस भी एक बहुत अच्छी स्पीसीज है हिबिस्कस में इतने सारे कलर्स मिलते हैं रेड से लेके येलो वाइट ऑरेंज और इसकी मेडिसिनल इम्पोर्टेंस भी है इसको आप अगर घर में लगाएंगे तो इसकी अगर आप चाय पियेंगे इन फूलों की स्पेशल रेड कलर के फ्लावर्स के तो आपका हीमोग्लोबिन बूस्टअप रहेगा और ये डाइजेशन के लिए भी बहुत अच्छा होता है तो ये आप जरूर लगाए हिबिस्कस के प्लांट आपके घर में ओलियंडर स्पीसीज है जो फ्लावरिंग में रहती है थ्रू आउट द ईयर बहुत अच्छा लुक देती है इजीली ग्रो कर सकते हैं और इसमें आपको ज्यादा केयर की भी जरूरत नहीं है और इसी के पास ये फाइकस है फाइकस बेंजामिना फाइकस की सारी स्पीसीज आप लगा सकते हैं अपने गार्डन में फिर बैम्बू का आप यूज कीजिए बैम्बू की काफी सारी स्पीसीज हैं और हमारे नेटिव प्लांट है बैम्बू बहुत अच्छा लगेगा गार्डन में एक बहुत ही एलिगेंट लुक देता है बहुत ही स्पिरिचुअलिटी से भी हमें कनेक्ट करता है बैम्बू दिस इज बुद्ध बैम्बू व्हेन इट कम्स टू प्लांट सिलेक्शन फॉर होम गार्डनिंग फॉर आउटडोर गार्डनिंग देयर इज अ बेटर स्कोप बिकॉज देयर इज नो लिमिटेशन ऑफ लाइट व्हेन इट कम्स टू इंडोर गार्डनिंग देयर इज लिमिटेशन लाइट Here I'm showing some of the trees like this one, Golden Shower, Amaltas. It just looks beautiful, yellow color flowers and the whole tree becomes yellow, especially in summer. So it just looks awesome. Then this pink acacia, that is Acacia renicera, pink color flowers and especially in summers it flowers and it also looks awesome. So you should have this such kind of trees near your home, in your home garden. Then this is Pride of India, that is Legistromia speciosa, beautiful tree. Even the pods are also beautiful, especially in June. You can see the pods developing and the pods you can dry out and you can use them as dry flowers also. Then this beautiful tree that is Michaelia champaka, beautiful flower and highly fragrant. You can just pluck one flower and keep in your room. The whole room becomes the fragrance fills up the whole room, and you can just feel the freshness and the fragrance of this flower. It's just awesome. Then this Butea monosperma palash, beautiful tree, orange color flowers, bright orange color flowers, and very good for your health also if you consume it. Then this Ashok tree, that is Saraka Ashoka, beautiful tree with orange color flowers. It is medium in height, the tree, and you can have it near your home. Not a large tree, so it is recommended. Then this Bohemia purpurea, also medium in texture, medium in height, you can grow them. Then this Stechoma argentea, yellow color flowers, and it also looks awesome because when it flowers, the whole tree becomes yellow. Then this Dahlonyx regia, that is Gulmohar, Polyarthia longifolia, these are the trees also you can select. Then Plumeria, beautiful trees available in yellow, white colors, oranges also. Plumeria alba, Plumeria rubra, beautiful trees because they are highly fragrant and near your home entrance especially. They just look beautiful. And when the flowers fall, you can feel the texture of ground also changes. Then Smanusox, Alengi, Cordia sebastiana, these are the trees very small in size, medium texture. And foliage trees or evergreen you can select for your home gardening. You can also have them in indoors. Then in shrubs, Ixora, it's a beautiful shrub available in pink, red, yellow, white color. And especially for tropical, subtropical region, it is very, very nice plant because throughout the year it is in flowering. So this also you can select. Then Ecalypha hispida, it is a beautiful foliage plant. You can grow them to get a different texture, different color texture in your home garden. A nice variety it gives. You can also use it as a hedge. Then this Parijat, that is Nyctanthus arbortristis. It's a beautiful shrub again, and the flowers are highly fragrant. It is also having herbal importance, flowers of it. Then Galphemia, small in size, small in height, and it's a nice shrub. Then this Alamanda cathartica, beautiful climber, yellow, bright yellow color. You can have it on your arc. You can also trellis on your roof, beautiful climber. Beautiful colors, bright yellow colors it has. And this one, Rangoon creeper, Quisqualis indica, Madhu Malti, jise bolte hain. Bahut hi pyare si climber hai because jab phool aate hain, the pura pink color ho jata hai. It has got mild fragrance, beautiful climber. Then Bougainvillea, you can always grow it in your home. Where if you don't have much time to give water, I would recommend this Bougainvillea. And you can have it in different colors, pink, orange, white. And you can have it, you can trail it on a climb, on a stand, or you can have it in the, nearby the parapet or near the corners. Then this Campsis, beautiful trumpet climber, bright orange color flowers. Then this Adenocallima aliaceum, that is garlic vine, beautiful climber, which is lavender in color, especially in January, February flowers. And it looks awesome because the whole climber becomes lavender in color. Then this Clematis acacia, such are the climbers which are white in color and highly fragrant. You can have it near your home. You should grow them. You can climb, make them climb on a stand. Then this Jasminum auriculatum, that is Juhi. Juhi is a beautiful climber. You can trail it on the earth. And when you enter your home garden, and if you have this Juhi, It makes you feel happy instantly because the fragrance you feel, it is just amazing. Beautiful climber. You can develop such kind of small garden in the front of your home. You can use a small waterfall with some rocks and small shrubs. Such kind of garden you can develop at the front area. If you have a larger area, you can have your own kitchen garden at the back side, where you can grow your own vegetables. You can trail them, different kind of vegetables. Then herbals, you should have. Like, you should develop herbal garden where you can grow your own licorice, basil, ginger, long pepper, kiloy, ashwagandha, brahmi. So, ye is tarah ke herbs hain jo aapko zarur lagana chahiye. Fir आप मिंट और ग्रीन टी यू ऑल्सो कैन हैव. देन कंपोस्टिंग इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज वेन यू हैव योर ओन गार्डन यू शुड डेवलप द हैबिट ऑफ मेकिंग योर ओन कंपोस्ट. सो हियर यू कैन यूज द किचन वेस्ट दैट इज लेफ्ट ओवर्स ऑफ फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स एंड you can add some little buttermilk and then cover it with soil and keep it humid and keep it covered. So within 40-45 days you can develop your own compost and you can use it in your home garden. So that way you can have this eco-friendly approach and you can develop your own compost. And this is what I would recommend. If you have a big space, you can have your own lawn, you can have good flower bed and that way. But if there is for space for a city, like if you don't have much space, then still you can have indoor gardening. You can be creative. So if you can utilize your balcony, it is very good. Small spaces also you can utilize, like some of these photographs, a small space with some sitting arrangement with some small shrubs, then such kind of petunia flowering plants you can have on stand, then vertical garden you can develop nearby the wall. Then there's a big range where you can go ahead with container gardening, lot of flowering plants and foliage plants you can select for your home garden. Aglaonema, Caladiums, Cycas, Diefenbachias, Ficus species, lots of plants, lots of palms are available where you can select and grow them in your home garden. Ficus, as I said earlier, then this Anthurium, bromeliads, then orchids, you can easily grow them. Then lots of cactus and also you can grow. You can see here bougainvillea, amaltas, alamanda, which is this is especially monsoon flowering. Bougainvillea looks awesome for home garden as well, and with least care you can grow it. Palms have its own importance, and especially if there is tropical climate, palms really look very beautiful. Here you can see this Lapis excelsa. It's looking so nice. And on my other side, we have got this Erica palm, Chrysalidocarpus. It's huge, grown huge, so you can have it near your home in some corners. And you can also grow both these plants in indoor conditions as well. You will see this beautiful fragrant tree, that is beautiful champa plumeria, and they are pink in color, dark pink in color, and fragrant too. The tree really looks beautiful. It has some spiritual effect when you grow them near your home, and when these flowers fall, they just change the texture as well of the ground. The tree is just beautiful. This is a beautiful
ma'am, can you please check your internet connectivity? I think there is some internet bandwidth problem with Dr. Alka Singh. We'll just try to connect to her immediately. So we'll try to reconnect to Dr. Alka Singh because I think there was some connectivity issue from her end. Taking the webinar forward, I'd like to request our associate partner, Mr. Satyen, who is the co-founder from Nursery Life today. He's present with us. So I'd like to request him to speak about his venture, Nursery Life, for another next 2 minutes.
Thanks, Manjeet. I hope I'm audible well. Thanks for giving this opportunity. So let me tell you a little bit about ourselves. So Nursery Live is a platform which kind of delivers plants, seeds, and various garden accessories across the country. And what we try to do is try to bridge the gap between our existing nursery partners. So currently, let's say if I'm a nursery, so probably I am serving in my local area. But what we are trying to do is those plants or those customers which you might not have been able to serve. So what we do is your product, we are trying to reach to the customers which are difficult, probably we would not have been reached there. So I mean, I really like to congratulate Manjeet for this platform. So I think Bizomia could be a great platform where like the whole industry or the nursery sector can be connected, where like maybe nurseries can trade with each other, or like we can fulfill our demand from each other. So I think that's a great platform. So Manjeet, congratulations for it, and I wish all the best for you.
Thank you Satendra. We are still in our try to connect to Dr. Alka Singh. There is some connectivity problem from her, and I don't know what's the connection.
And I think this overall platform is also great, like where you are conducting these webinars. So these are very informative. So I think we are doing this third webinar, and I think the quality of content and quality of speakers are really good. And
thank you so very much.
We learn a lot from it.
Okay, so taking the webinar forward, you can be there with me as the co-screen today, till the time we get the connect with Dr. Alka Singh. So taking the webinar forward, since last webinar we had introduced a unique concept of getting into this question answer round. So what we are doing is that instead of getting live questions on board today, because it's very tough for us to get all the questions answered at such a short span of time. So what we are doing, we are putting three questions today from our side. And that will have multiple choices there. So all the participants, it will be an open thing for you all to participate in this. So once the questions are there, you just put up your answer along with the answer of your choice, along with your email ID. Don't share your mobile number because it's the public platform. So what you can do is you can just share your answer along with your email ID. So the top 10 winners will be getting a very attractive gift hamper from our sponsoring agency, Gardenia Technologies India today. So we'll take this forward. So the first question on board today. The first question is that what is the main concept behind spiritual farming? So I'll repeat the question again. What is the main concept behind spiritual farming? And the options are worshipping plants, offering plant products to God. C, understanding that plants have consciousness. D, performing puja for plants' welfare. So I'll repeat the options again. A, worshipping plants. B, offering plant products to God. C, understanding that plants have consciousness. And D, performing puja for the plant welfare. So this is the first question. So what you are supposed to do, you are just supposed to type your answer in the chat box, which is public now. And along with your option, the answer as the option, and your email ID. Now going forward for the second question. The second question is based on our sponsoring agency. The Gardenia technology produced are manufactured in which country? The options are, it's made in India, made in China, made in Vietnam, or made in Italy. So you can Google them immediately and try to find out the answer, the correct answer for this question. So basically, we are asking that the Gardenia technologies products are manufactured in which country? Made in India, made in China, made in Vietnam, or made in Italy. So I had already given the answer in my presentation when I started this whole webinar. The third question is basically, which plant species should be preferred for organic home gardening? I'm repeating the question. Which plant species should be preferred for organic home gardening? And the options are exotic, B, imported, C, trees and shrubs, and D, native plants. So these are the three questions. These questions will keep coming on your screen. What you are supposed to do, you are just supposed to type the answer along with your email ID in the chat box. And the top lucky 10 winners will be getting the free gift hamper from our sponsor agency, Gardenia Technologies. That is there. And we have seen lot many questions there on our screen regarding the e-certificate. So what you are supposed to do, you are just supposed to put up your email ID along with all the information required to fill up the form, and there you can download your form immediately, the e-certificate immediately. I think we are connected again with Dr. Alka Singh. Alka ma'am, can you hear me? I think there is some serious internet bandwidth problem at our end. So, because we are very much running constant with the time, we are doing this whole webinar in the time span of 50 minutes only, and we had already crossed 5 minutes post 50. So I'd like to wrap up the entire webinar series today. I'd like to thank both of our speaker, Dr. Rajshekhar Patlori and Dr. Alka Singh. And further, I'll request my colleague, Mr. Deepak Chatterjee, who is from my team. He's the director who is serving there with Bizomia. And so he'll be introducing the second topic of the webinar, which is scheduled the next Saturday at the very same time, 4 to 4:50.
Yeah, good evening, everyone. And we have a... Yeah, good evening, everyone. Hello, hello. Yeah, we have a series of this You, Me and Green. On that series now, already we have three webinars very successfully done. Thank you for all the participants. Now we have a series on the fourth webinar will be on 26th of June. That is on micro organics and this organic biofertilizer, the topics. And we have very prominent two speakers with us, Dr. P.C. Rai, as well as Dr. Deshpande. They all are very senior in this industry. And we have already made the creative. Can you show the creative? Yeah, for the next webinar. You all are welcome. Now, many thanks to Dr. Alka Singh, as well as Mr. Rajshekhar ji. And now you all are invited for our next webinar. Thank you.